Okay, I think there's most of the people joined already, and we can just start, and the others will follow up. So
Perfect.
yeah, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is a global webinar today, so thank you all for joining from the different parts of the world, and welcome to our today's webinar about how to care for your Gastric Aerosol Monitor from calibration to best practices. And before going to start with the content, I just wanted to introduce myself in the beginning. My name is Nina Sander. I'm working as Health and Safety Application Specialist at TSI and mostly focused on Europe, but also Africa and Middle East. Max, why don't you introduce
Yeah,
yourself?
hi everyone. My name's Maxine Dolloway. I am the Direct Sales Specialist for TSI in the UK.
Okay, perfect. So you know who we are. And now I would quite shortly present you what you will learn today in that webinar. We want first to take a look at why instrument cleaning and calibration is so critical. Afterwards, take a look at the different options for you to address your service needs with TSI. And as the last step, take a look at the best practices to take care of your devices. And yeah, talking about devices, I just wanted to show you what devices we are today talking about. So we are talking about the big group of our Gastrec family. So the Gastrec 2 and DRX family, the desktop instruments, the desktop instrument with external pump, as well as our handheld models. With the yeah, our part of the presentation. And we want to start to give you just an overview about globally where can you send your Gastrec instrument for service, and we prepared this map for you. I would start on the left side with the yeah, orange location bubble, and I think you all know our headquarters in, from TSI in Shoreview, Minnesota, in the US. So this is, of course, where we manufacture the instrument and where our biggest service location is located. Then in the middle of the map, you see the blue point. This is for High Wycombe in UK. This is our European and Middle Eastern service center. And you do see in Asia, we do have two service centers, one in Beijing in China and one in Singapore. And all of you can just send the instrument directly to one of these four service centers. Just a very quick note for But just a few for you customers within the European Union, you can send your device to the German office from TSI, which will then send the instrument to the UK service center. But the rest of you, so most of you, can send it to us directly to have a quick and fast service process. Okay, so now you know where to send the instrument, but why is cleaning calibration critical and also why do you sh or should send your instrument? And there are different reasons and benefits behind cleaning and calibration of the Gastrec instruments. With cleaning and calibration at TSI, you ensure that the Gastrec is uptime and still have a precision measurement. You can identify and address potential issues with using our cleaning and calibration offer and extend the lifespan of your instrument. And just the very important note here that if you want to follow the manufacturer's recommendations, so our recommendations here, we are recommending to send all Gastrecs annually to calibration at TSI. When talking about calibration at the manufacturer, so at TSI for the Gastrecs, there are multiple benefits that are, yeah, going on with that. The first one is that you ensure that the instrument meets the manufacturer's tested specifications, so that's what's written down in the spec sheets. Also, you can make sure that that you have the ability to make calibration adjustments, or not you personally, but our technicians are able to make calibration adjustments. This is quite unique compared to the third service parties. Also, you do always get the latest software and firmware updates when you send your instruments to TSI. Also, you if you if needed, so if we found out or our technicians found out during cleaning and calibration that there are some issues with the instrument, some repairs necessary, they are performed with original parts that are built into the instruments. Also, as you, I think, all know, when the instrument was delivered and when you send your instruments to clean and calibration, that we as TSI always provide a NIST traceable calibration certificate to be sure that this calibration is valid. The next point is, if you send the instrument to TSI, you get the benefit of being insured you keep working with a high precise, reliable instrument. And the last and I think most important point is that with using the TSI service, you take advantage of the manufacturer's expertise, because we build the instrument and our technicians build the instruments, so they do know best the instruments and do know best how to handle them. And I just wanted to quickly show you this table, because they are listed all the advantages and benefits you get with using the TSI factory service, and in comparison with third-party services, because there are a lot out there, and they do quite a good job in leak checking and as fault calibration check, but as you can see on the table, none of the other benefits are involved there. And I think the most important point on the table is the bottom down, that you do get S left calibration, because this is the important thing. After things were cleaned, after things were calibrated, after things were repaired, maybe every time you send it to TSI service and get the instrument back, you do get an S left calibration. It can be sure that when you receive your instrument back, that it's in a good working condition. Okay. Then you hopefully now know why calibration is critical, and Max now will show you about the process.
Okay, so we've got a couple of slides now which detail how you go about sending your instrument back into service for calibration or for repair. So first of all, we'll talk about how you log in. You can either log in with your TSI account, and I'll give you the link in the next slide. Or you can continue as a guest. Then you can request your service online, pack and ship your instrument back to your TSI service centre. And then the service will be carried out by our expert teams, and then your unit will be shipped back to you with a calibration certificate. If you're unsure of any of this process, you can always contact your local partner or TSI representative as well. Next slide, please. So this is a bit more in depth. So you can access the website to return your unit for calibration or repair by using the link there. And then you fill out your company information, fill out your instrument information. So you will need your serial number of your instrument, which is on the back of the instrument. And then you click Get Service Options. So there's several options from the drop-down box, and there's also an option to fast track your instrument if you need it back faster. Really important to fill out the return reason and special requirement box. Sometimes this gets missed, but it does help our engineers kind of pinpoint what if it's in for repair. It does help them to pinpoint what the problem is. So if you can give as much detail in those boxes as you possibly can, and that will help the service engineers tremendously. So once you've done that, you just click the next box. And if you want to add in any other instruments, you can do by following the same steps, 3 to 5 as above, and then click next when all the instruments have been added. There is a link at the bottom of the slide which gives you a step-by-step process of how to complete a service RMA, we call them. So yeah, you will be getting copies of these presentations, so you will have that resource then if should you need it. So when you send your instrument in for service, the process starts. We've got standard service options, and then we've got a fast track calibration service. So the standard tends to be, once we receive the instrument, it tends to be around 3 to 5 working days, and then it will be shipped back to yourselves. The fast track service does then, for an extra additional charge, you can it makes your instrument top of the pile, so it is a lot quicker calibration service. when you ship your instrument back in for calibration or repair, it's really, really important to also send the accessories that come with it, should you think there's an issue with them. So with the dust track, always send back your zero filters. If they're broken or damaged, these can be replaced. Certainly the power lead batteries, if you've had problems with power, and also if you've had communication problems with laptops, also send in the computer cable, because they can test that cable to make sure they've tried to replicate the problem that you're having. So it will help the engineers to solve the problem if you're having issues. So now I'm going to talk about the different offerings that we have in service. So there's multiple options or packages to address your service needs. So customers can request a single clean and calibration or a single repair, clean and calibration. And so the calibration product codes start with a CL. So we have those for all different models of the Porticount. And then the repair, clean and calibrate codes all begin with RP. So we offer that as a one-off service or one-off repair for all instruments in the dust track range. And then we've got packages. So we've got our Quality Guard calibration service plans, which you can either opt for a 2-year calibration package paid up front or a 3-year calibration. And these start with the product code CLC2 for 2 years and CLC3 for 3 years. And then, as I said, for the previous slides, we offer these packages for all dust track models. And then finally, we've got our Quality Guard bumper to bumper service plans. Now, these can only be purchased when you buy a new instrument. So at the time of buying, you can buy these alongside. We've got two options. You've got a 3-year calibration package and a 5-year calibration package, and they also extend the warranty to the time period for the package. So the B2B 3 package includes 3 calibrations, plus it extends the warranty of the instrument to 3 years. Normal warranty of the instrument is 2 years. And as just to repeat, the bumper to bumper can only be purchased when you're buying a new instrument.
Okay, so now you know how the service process works and what options do you have to get our service at TSI. And but there's also things you can take care of before service or on the other hand of service. And I now want to present you the best practices for caring for your dust track instruments. And we want to start with normal maintenance, and there's very important, and I think the importance of doing and performing zero checks before each use is sometimes forgotten. So I just wanted to remind you that every time you use your dust track instrument, you should perform a zero check before each use. And if you're using your dust track desktop models, mostly with the external pump, for continuous monitoring, then please make use of the auto zero module that you can get with TSI. Why is zero check performing important? Because zero calibration reduces the drift from temperature or contamination best possible, so it makes your measurements more reliable. Also, you should do some cleaning for the dust track DRX, the cleaning of the 2.5 micrometer calibration impactor, and for the dust track 2, for all size selective inlets. And also here, it's very important that you do these cleaning procedures before each use of the size selective inlets. I will present you how the cleaning process looks like in a few slides. Also, something that's important about cleaning is the inlet of the instrument itself. And there you find the rule within the manual that you have to clean the inlet after the 350 hours at 1 milligram per cubic meter. So what does that mean? The cleaning necessity of the inlet is depending on how much aerosol the pump soaked into the instrument. And you can say that if the aerosol concentration is at 1 milligram per cubic meter, you have to clean the inlet every 350 hours. If you're measuring in higher concentrations, then you have to clean the inlet more often. If you're measuring in lower concentrations, the time can be extended. And this is called the prorating to instrument use. So if we have 350 hours at 1 milligram per cubic meter, and you would measure in a doubled aerosol concentration of 2 milligram per cubic meter, you would have to clean the inlet every 175 hours. If you're measuring in lower concentrations, like 0.5 milligram per cubic meter, you would have to clean the inlet every 700 hours. Then there's an internal cleaning necessary with the instrument, because as you can imagine, there are tubes, flowways, etc. But this is not field or user service LB. So this is what is included in the TSI cleaning process when you send it for clean and calibration. So this has to be done annually. What you can do on yourself in the field is, if you're working with the external pump, then you should replace annually the internal HEPA filters within the external pump. The next steps for maintenance is the replacement of the internal filters. Also here, you do get the knowledge about every 350 hours at 1 milligram per cubic meter. Also, this is prorated. But there's also an additional case when you should replace your internal filters in the DustTrack instruments, if indicated by the main screen by a filter error. So you know, if you remember how the main screen of the DustTrack looks like, you have the word filter with a normal green bubble point in front. And if this is going to be red and a filter error message appear, then you should replace the internal filters. If you're working with the DustTrack handheld instruments, you do have two internal filters inside that should be changed and replaced. If you're working with the DustTrack desktop model, you only have one internal filter that you can replace by yourself. But this is additionally, you should also take out the filter cassette and clean it before putting it back into the instrument. What's quite important for both models, so handheld and desktop models, is that after you replace the internal filters, you go to the setup menu within the DustTrack and reset the filter, the instrument's filter counter, that the instrument knows that it's a new filter, and start counting the amount of aerosol again. Best practice for caring for the instrument is also be aware of the right storage conditions. So if you want to store your DustTracks for more than 30 days, it's important that you charge the battery before and then remove the battery and do not leave it inside the instrument. The second aspect that's quite important for storage is keep in account the storage temperature you can find in the spec sheets of the instrument. And this is between minus 20 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius, or more, minus 4 up to 140 degrees Fahrenheit, depending on the scale you're using. But it's quite important to keep the instrument in this storage conditions, that there is no damage on the instruments. And just the quick note, be aware then when you want to use the instrument again, that you take a look at the operational temperature, not just the storage temperature. Okay, with that, I want to show you about the cleaning process as promised, and we'll start with the inlet cleaning. So for cleaning the inlet of the instrument, turn off the DustTrack monitors. That's quite important. Afterwards, you can unscrew the inlet nozzle, as you can see on the picture, and then clean this inlet. From the outside, just use a cotton swab that's damped with water or light solvent like isopropanol. And inside, you can also use a small brush with a light solvent. Afterwards, it's very important that you dry the tube by blowing it out with compressed air or let it air dry thoroughly. And it's very important, if you're using compressed air, that you have to be careful to not blow particles into the DustTrack monitor's inlet port. So just use the compressed air side of the DustTrack, so not on the near of the inlet, and just dry the inlet nozzle there. Afterwards, please screw in the inlet again, and it's very important here just to use your own hands, so hand tighten the inlet and don't use any other tools to tighten it, because then it can easily broke. And this is the process for inlet cleaning process, and I know that in practice it's looking somehow different, so I want to point out here, this is the only process for inlet cleaning. Do not clog the inlet with your finger while it's running in order to clear the inlet of visible debris, because then the visible debris is not in the inlet anymore. That might be, but it is in the optical chamber. You have high contamination within the instruments. You have to send the instrument for calibration, cleaning and calibration to us. And of course, clogging the inlet is also not good for the pump inside the instrument. So please only use the first shown process of cleaning the inlet. Then cleaning the site selective inlets, starting with the impactors, that's independent of it's the impactors for the Dustrix 2 or the one impactor for the Dustrix DRX. This is valid for all different impactors. Start and unscrew the impactor and check if the O-ring on the impactor base is still on its place, or if it looks broken, you might need a replacement, and also clean it from visible debris. And then you should clean outside and inside of the impactor, as well as the impactor plate. And also here you can use a brush or a swab and a light solvent. Then again, it's quite important that you dry all parts by blowing it out with compressed air or let it air drying thoroughly. And it's quite important for the impactor plate as well. Please give it time to dry completely before doing the next step. Because the next step when cleaning impactors is that you have to apply 2 drops of impactor oil, which are included with the instrument, to the impactor plate. And as you can all imagine, if it would be still wet, water and oil, the connection is not that good. So let it dry thoroughly before you applying the 2 drops of oil. And it's also important that you just do this 2 drops of oil and do not overfill the impactor plate. And I would also every time recommend it to start with 1 droplet, let it some seconds time to be soaked from the plate, and then apply the 2nd droplet. After you applied the oil, you can put everything back together and screw it together. And also here, please just hand tighten the impactor. If you're working with the Dore Oliver cyclone on the Dustrix 2, also here you start with unscrewing the grid port and remove the cyclone clip, as well as pulling off the cap. And for dislodged particles, you take the grid port and just hold the open end down, tap it on the hard surface, the same you are repeating with the cyclone body, and then normally most of the particles should be already outside the cyclone. If you take a look into the cyclone and see some visible dirt inside, you can use blow can pressurized air to the cyclone parts, or clean them with soap and water or a mild solvent like isopropanol. And especially for the cyclone, it's very, very important that you let it perfectly dry. While with the impactor or the inlet, you might see if it's still wet or already dry. You cannot see it with the very sensitive structures and not good visible structures that are existing inside the cyclone. So really give it enough time to dry perfectly before you then reassemble the cyclone again. Another thing you should keep in mind during your cleaning process is the inlet tubing. So you know that with the Dustrix we deliver this black tubing. If you need some tubing to reach the area in which you want to take your aerosol from. And next to cleaning, there are some best practices to reduce the cleaning I want to present to you. It's very important that you only use conductive tubing, so the black one we deliver with the instrument. And if you lost it, you have to order it back from ourselves, because if you use different tubing with a different material, you will have a big number of particle loss inside the tubing. And this, of course, increases the cleaning necessity, but also Yeah, influences your measurement results when there's a big particle loss in the tubing. So please use only the conductive tubing that's delivered with the instrument. And always keep in mind that if you have to use the tube, keep it as short as possible and keep it as straight as possible without loops and kinks to decrease the particle deposition inside the tubing. If you do have to clean the tubing, you can just simply blow it out with compressed air for cleaning. Then there has to be cleaned the tubing inside the instrument and all other parts, but this is not user field serviceable, and this is done with a TSI clean and calibration. If you want to just reassure yourself about what I just presented to you, we do have a nice video for the infield cleaning and maintenance process on the DustTrack monitors. You can find the video on Vimeo and as well as on YouTube. We put the links there, and if the slides are shared with you afterwards, you can watch them and be assured with the cleaning processes. Max?
Thanks, Janina. So we just got some resources to give you a bit more information about the things that we've talked about today. So there's a link at the top there for the instrument manual for all the DustTrack models. There's a link which takes you to a piece which talks about why you're calibrating your instruments at the manufacturer is important. There's a link to the TSI guide on how to submit service requests. The TSI service blog, that includes tips on how to extend the life of your instrument, as well as talking about the various ISO accreditations that we have. And then you've got the TSI service infographics, which is a piece of information that gives us information about what customers think of the TSI service in 2022. And the bottom link is for support and service information, which is a link to our website where you can download the latest software updates. You can find a distributor or a representative that covers your territory. And we talk about the TSI global locations as well in that link. Some useful contacts for you, depending on the region that you're from. We've got technical support, so we've got the US and global technical support email and contact number for EMEA. We've got a different one, and then we've got another one for the UK. And also we've got product and application support. So Greg Olson is our US and global product specialist. Janina is for the EMEA, and then we've got Sophia who covers Asia Pacific. Or alternatively, you can reach out to your local sales representative who will happily point you in the right direction. So this is a bit of a busy slide, but basically it's every service offering that we have for all of the DustTrack models. So it covers the 8530 on the left, all the different packages that you can get for that, the 8030 external pump, all the packages for that. The handheld 8032, the 8533 EP, and 8534 handheld DRX. So that's everything that we offer. But like I say, if you can find, there's lots of different product codes and numbers, please contact your local sales representative and they'll be more than happy to point you in the right direction.
Okay. Perfect. Then I already saw some questions in the questions and answer books. We will now go through them and answer them. And please feel free to also write your questions in there now, and we will have enough time to go through all of them. And I will start with the first question to Max. You presented the Quality Guard Calibration Contract, so the CLC contracts. Mm-hmm. And the question is if they can be subscribed at any time, so even if the DustTrack equipment was bought 1, 2, or 10 years ago.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah, they can be purchased at any time. It's only the B2B contracts which extend the warranty. They can only be purchased at the time of buying the DustTrack new, but the calibration CLC2 and CLC3, they can be purchased at any time.
Okay, then there's one question very specific from India who wanted to send their instrument to service and are requesting if it's possible to send the device via TSI India, not directly to US. And Adrian, I think it's best you're the product manager, if you could answer that question.
Correct. I already answered to Santosh. Thank you for the question. Yep.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I saw. Okay, that's a very specific question, so it's answered in written. Then I do have a question. I think it's also for Max. The question about what is the average time difference between a standard and a fast track service?
It's about roughly 2 days difference.
Okay, thank you. Then I have one question. I think this is for myself. It's a company renting the instrument at a rental company, and the rental company calibrates the machines. And I would suggest you that you check with this rental company if they calibrate the instrument themselves, because then it's not a recommended calibration, or if they send then the instrument to calibration with TSI. Because if the rental company is the only one calibrating the instrument, it's the same as with an other third party service provider, and you do not have the right materials, the original materials. You do not have the latest firmware and all the table we showed in between. So it's maybe best to get in contact with your rental company and check if they are sending the instrument to us.
Just to add to that as well, you can also check if it's been calibrated at TSI, because there will be a sticker on the underside which will date the last calibration. So you can also see when the next calibration is due as well.
Okay, then there's an interesting question about cleaning of the impactors if it's used for continuous sampling. So the question is, what are the recommended cleaning procedures for continuous sampling? How often do impactor plates need to be re-oiled in this configuration? And the answer here is not very easy, because it really much depends on what aerosol you're measuring. So I think it's easiest, you do get our contact details. I think I gave the slide back with the contact details. I don't see currently where you're located, but if you choose Greg, me, or Sophia, depending on where you are located, and ask this question directly via email or phone with some information about your specific measurements and your specific aerosols, because then the recommendation can be more situated to your specific situation.
Yeah, I think
Yeah.
there's a question that we've missed. What about zero calibration?
Yeah, this was in the part. So the zero calibration is recommended to do every time before use. And if you're also using it there, the Auto Zero module for continuous sampling, also there it very much depends if you're measuring indoor with constant conditions, or if you're measuring outdoor with the environmental enclosure and have different shifts in temperature. That's very much depending on the specific application. So I would recommend to just get in touch with us and describe your specific application, and then you can get the best recommendation also on how you do the setting of the Auto Zero module. That's a good point, Max. Okay, then there's the one question. Is it possible to have the PowerPoint presentation by email, please? I think it definitely is. So the PowerPoint will be sent out and the recording as well to everyone who joined the webinar. Then there's a question, maybe Mexican or Luca or Adrian, someone of you can give a comment to that. This webinar is very helpful, so thank you for that. Are there plans to offer these for other products as well?
Yes, definitely. All right, this is Adrian. Definitely we want to offer to more products. So if you have a specific products be interested, please leave it in the comments. We'd like to see that. That's something this team is taking and looking into to address different products as well.
Okay, perfect. Thank you for that. Then there's a question, what are the troubleshooting steps when the monitor is recording zeros or negative values? Okay, That's a tricky question there. Please check the flow of the instrument, or to check if maybe after the last, your last cleaning process, excuse me, please. If you put in everything correctly, so if you put back in the filter correctly, if you put back in the filter cassette correctly, because often negative readings appear when there is a big flow difference. So maybe you can also use a flow meter to check if the flow is correct. And if it then still appears, then maybe you should get in contact with our technical support, and they can then guide you through forwarding steps if the flow is not the issue there. Then there's a question. Do TSI have an update program? We are owner of an old TSI equipment, and we would like to upgrade it to a newer model. And maybe Max or Adrian?
Yeah, I mean, what I would recommend in that instance, I'm not sure where the customer is from, but if they could get in touch with the local representative, they would be able to answer that and offer them a trade-in, possibly. So, if you want to just let us know where you're from, and we can pass on the details of the representative that covers your area.
Okay, then there's a question about a quite old instrument, so older than 10 years, but annually calibrated. And the question is, can you advise our unit can still be used for more years to come by maintaining the calibration, since our unit keep on failed to do zero calibration recently? This is quite hard to answer from the distance, because it can either be a quite, let's say, normal issue that can easily be fixed during a next clean and calibration process. Or of course, after more than 10 years, it could also be a greater issue, but this is something our service technicians could find out when it's with the calibration for the repair and calibration for the next time. They check it if it's an easy issue, maybe just a tube or whatever that can get broken.
Yeah.
So it's...
Sorry, go on.
Yeah.
I would definitely send it into service just to have a look.
Okay. Then there's a question regarding the Q-Track XP field calibrations. And I would like to ask you to just get in contact with one of the contact details showing on the slides, because this webinar focuses on the DustTrack family. And of course, for the Q-Track XP, the field calibration is completely different than with the DustTrack. Then there's a question, is there any resources available on when it would be best to use different particle size filters, such as the 2 mm versus 10 micron filters? We use ours for environmental monitoring, so do not attach them, but is this the best way? This is very much depending on what you're interested in. Why are you measuring? Do you want to comply with special regulations? They are normally referring to a specific particle size. So then, of course, you should measure this particle size. I think this is also, you get in contact with even your local sales representative or with Greg, Sophia, and me, and we can take a detailed look at your application. There's a question, what is the troubleshooting if the instrument is measuring higher than it is supposed? Example, 2.5 milligram instead of 0.025 milligram. I would guess that this is so you know, we didn't touch it in this webinar, but as you know, with working with the DustTrack, you do have the photometric calibration or correction factors within the software. And I could imagine that the aerosol you're measuring is just depending different than the calibration aerosol. This is an ISO test dust. And then you can handle this with the photometric correction factors implemented in the software. But if you're interested there in more information on them, you do find some app notes on our homepage, and I think the link should be in the resources slide. And if they are not helping, then just get in contact with us and we can send you more information about the photometric correction factor. Okay, there's the request, maybe Adrian, for you to note to have such a district just such a service webinar also for the port account. I'm sorry, it's
yeah, great question. So we already did one this year, probably a couple of months ago, and that you can find the webinar on the tools, right? When we send these this information right to the participants, it will be addressed there, right? You can find the webinar in that link. Okay.
Okay, perfect. Then there's, I do see a last question. Can the cleaning operations described and the replacement of the internal filters at home solve a problem such as reading the same value for all fractions, PM1, PM2.5, PM respirable, PM10, and PM total? So this is a question related to the DustTrack DRX technology. Definitely these cleaning operations can help, but I would always keep in mind to also ask, or have the customer ask himself, if it couldn't be true, if just the particles they are measuring are just so small that because PM1 is a part group of PM2.5 and PM2.5 is a part group of PM respirable and this is a part group of PM10 and so on. So if there are only very small particles, it's true that they are all the same. But of course, cleaning can help you solve that. Then ask yourself if it couldn't be just the correct reading. And the third suggestion I would make is check if the photometric calibration factor and with the DRX also the size correction factor could change the result and make it more valid for your specific aerosol. That's an interesting question. If you use the two DustTrack DRX for co-location measures, what is the percentage allowed for difference between them? And that's quite interesting because we do have an app note for that. And the question is always, what is co-location? And often people send me a picture and, oh, we do have two co-located instruments here. And one is situated at the bottom and 3 meters further. In 3 meters here, there's the second instrument, and this is not co-located. And even if you do have it completely co-located, photometric or optical measurement instruments always have a small difference. So there's not the one value we can give you. It very much depends, and I would suggest that you take a look at our website and search for the specific app note where we talk about. If you can't find it, just write us an email and we can share this app note with you. It's very good explained in it there. Okay. Just give you a short moment to if there's a new question arising, and because I think this was the last one. And there's a question. Could you share the note with the email after the presentation? I think, yes, this is possible that we include it in the email or Luca. Can we add another app note to the email that goes out to everyone?
Yes, we'll send a thank you email to everyone. We'll make sure to include also that link.
Okay, perfect. Then I think this was the last question. So we are perfectly in time, I would say. Thank you very much for your attention, for your good questions and a good discussion we had here. Max, do you have something to add?
No, I just wanted to say thank you everyone for taking the time out to be on this webinar today. And if you've got any questions that you think of following, then please let one of us know on one of the emails. Probably Janina, I don't mind me saying this, but probably Janina, if you're a point of contact first, because you know you're the face of the webinar, and then you could distribute it.
Yeah, definitely.
That would be great. So yeah, thank you everyone for all your time today.
Okay, yeah. Thank you everyone, and have a nice day. And hope to see you soon in another webinar or via email or phone contact. So thank you very much, everyone.